Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to show you this tutorial today. I'm going to show you how you can add audio files to any Canva design. So Canva is a free website you can go to create literally anything. If you want to create social media posts, presentations, videos, you name it. You can even create your own website on here, which is crazy cool. So I'm going to show you, like I said, how to add audio files into your designs. And you can even do, like, if you're starting a YouTube channel, you can, like me, you can even add, you know, your intro YouTube screen. You can create all of that on Canva. So that's what I'm going to show you today. I'm going to show you a couple different things that you can create with an audio file. You can do them for free, just on the free Canva plan if you want to, or you can upgrade to the pro plan and you can unlock the entire audio library if you want to. So what we're going to do first, I'm going to show you how to create kind of like a little YouTube intro video. You're going to go over here. You're going to go into Canva, create your free account, canva.com. I'll put a link in the description as well. And you're going to go over to create a design. And when you go over here, they have all different types of file formats that you can use. You can do a Facebook post, you can do Instagram post. It's already formatted for you to be the perfect size of what you would post on Instagram, which is really cool. I'm just going to go down here and say YouTube video chapter. If it doesn't pop up for you, you can just type in YouTube here on the search bar. And it's going to bring up all of these different options for you. So I'm just going to go, like I said, into YouTube video chapter. And it's going to pop up for you. The next thing you're going to do as soon as this pops up and you're ready to rock and roll is they're going to give you templates right over here. It's going to pop up already on your design tab. They're going to give you all these different templates that you can use for your video. This is one that I recently used. I just think it's, I don't know, I like it. So I'm just going to click that one and pick this one. And it's going to put that here on that first slide. So for me, what I did for my intro video, if you watched the beginning of this video, I created all of that in Canva as well. And I just took different snippets of trainings and recordings that I've done for other things. And I put them, I uploaded them to Canva here. You can upload your videos in here. And then I just added them per slide, boop, 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 and used an audio file. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So this is just what we can go with if we want to. If we see this design and we're like, I don't really like that one, we can scroll down and see if there's, like, look at that one. That's cool. We can add a new page if we want to. So now we have our first design here on that first slide, and then we have the second design here. They don't go together, but I'm just showing you that you can kind of build on each, you know, how you want it to look. You can build on each slide. If we don't like that, we're just going to go here to these three little bars and we're going to say, delete the page. We're not even going to mess with it. Okay. So what we have right now is that first little intro page. And now the moment you've been waiting for, how do we add audio? We're going to go, we're on this design tab now. We're going to scroll down here to elements. You're going to click on the element tab. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you're going to see videos, other videos that you can add in here and audio files right here. So we're going to click see all. And you can see right here, if you're on the upgraded pro plan, you can unlock the entire audio library if you want to. If not, then you're just going to scroll down and you're going to see any of the audio files that don't have the little crown. So this little crown, that's part of the pro plan. So if you wanted to use this one, but you didn't want to get the pro plan, you can totally do that. You would just add this. And then when you go up here to share and you download your file, it's going to say, okay, no problem, but you do have a premium element. So you'll have to pay for it. And this could be anywhere from like $1 to $2. It's really cheap if you just want to do one-off downloads like that. And you don't want to do the subscription pro plan, which is totally fine. But if you want to keep it all free, I'm just going to click on this one right here, and it's going to add that audio track right down here. Now I added it where my little cursor was. So if I want to move it, I'm just going to grab that cursor, take it back to the beginning, and I'm going to grab this audio file. Perfect. So we just added in that audio file and I'm just seeing, by using this play button, I'm just listening to what it looks like. Now, if I don't want that part of the song, I can adjust it. So I just clicked on these three little buttons that pop up here, and I'm going to say adjust. And when I do that, I'm going to be able to move my track. And so I can move it to a different part of the song, and I can play that piece, and maybe I like that better. Or maybe I'm going to move it even more because I like this part of the song even better than that first part. That's fun. That sounds good. So if I really like that, one thing that I like to do if you're making like an intro video or an outro video is to do fades. Ooh la la. So we're going to do a fade in and a fade out. So we're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to go in here. We're going to, so adjusting, we just did, moves the track back and forth so you can decide what you want, so which part of the song you want. And then we can go down here to audio effects. And when you go to audio effects, you're going to see fade in, fade out. So we can say fade in for like 3 seconds and fade out for 3 seconds. And you can adjust this. I moved it to 4 seconds. That's fine. You can adjust it and then you'll go back to play and see how it sounds. And you'll see it's going to play. It's going to fade in real quick and then play your song and then fade out. It's very gradual. So you can play with that. If you want a long fade in or a short fade in, it's totally up to you what you want to do. Once you have that, you're going to be all set. We're going to adjust. We checked our audio effects. We're going to go back down here. We can even, like, let's say you imported a video of you talking. You're like giving a presentation. You imported that video and you want like a little bit of audio song in the background. You can adjust the volume here. So you'll click on that and you'll say, I only want that song to play at 40%. That way you can still hear me talking over it, but you can also get a little bit of the music in the background. You can do that as well. How cool. And of course, when we have a template on here, we can adjust any of these words. We can adjust the background. Like, let's say we want to put a different video in the background. So we have our little intro. I'm going to make this a little bit longer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say duplicate page. So I just went back here and I said duplicate, boop. And I duplicated that. I'm going to go ahead and click on my audio and extend it like so. And then maybe I can add in different videos to the second slide and different words if I want to, of course. So this first one, maybe we'll be like, welcome to my channel. Yay! And then over here we can say, don't forget to subscribe. Then we can kind of just make it our own. And then maybe we decide, hey, I don't want this one back there. I'm just going to delete that and move my words up a little bit and put a different video in the background. So if I go again back to elements, if I go back to elements, I can get out of audio and I can go to video and I can say see all video. We can see the files that were recently used and we can see other ones that we can use. Ooh, I kind of like this one. So I'm just going to click, drag it into my background. You can see this video clip was 15 seconds and my audio clip is only 10 seconds. So we're going to extend our audio clip again just by clicking and extending. And now that this is longer, I think I'm actually just going to get rid of this slide. We're just going to delete that. Here we go. Let's see what it looks like. Welcome to my channel. Now it's going to fade out and you can continue on with your video if you want to. So this is a simple way that you can create an intro video if you want to for your YouTube channel. Now let's do one more thing. Maybe you're thinking, well, I don't have a YouTube channel. I just have social media posts. Like maybe I just have an Instagram. So let's go back to our homepage. Oh, one more thing. Of course, you're just going to go up here and say share. You're going to click download and you're going to download it in the MP4 video format. You say download and then you're good to go. We're going to go over here to Canva. So let's say we're going to do an Instagram post. It's going to be the exact same thing. We're going to click on Instagram post. It's going to pull up the perfect square for us for Instagram. And we're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to go into templates if you want to. You can click on a template that you think is really awesome. Add in your own pictures, add in your own text. And then what I kind of like to do, so what I like to do is I'll type in podcast. I'm going to get rid of this and show you this instead. I type in podcast. So a lot of people do the audiograms on Instagram. So I like this one. We can add in our own podcast image. We can add in the name, all of this stuff, right? But what we're going to do is I'm going to type in audio. We're going to do an audio effect so that people looking at our Instagram know that it's an audio file. And so we can pick one of these. This is kind of what I like to do. I'm going to get rid of this in the background. So I'm just going to click on that image, delete it. And then I'm going to position. So I click back on here. I'm going to position this to the back and extend it a little bit. Boop. That way it gives a little bit of movement so people can see that, yeah, it is actually an audiogram basically that we are creating. I'm going to adjust my background. I just like to type in color because it gives me lots of options. Maybe I'll pick this one for my background. And then I don't have a picture here. Maybe let's see. I'll just say laptop. And then we can go down here to any photos. And we can add those in right here. So it kind of goes with like the vibe of what we're doing a little bit better than what was already on there, maybe. I'm gonna change the background here. So when I click on here, the whole, all of the colors that are in this phone pop up, and I'm picking on the background color here, and I just wanna have it white, just make it simple. Then I'll click this little bar, I'll adjust that picture. Okay. Anyways, once we get this how we want it, whatever way we want it, again, we're going to go into elements, click there. And what you can do if you want it to just be, you know, any kind of audio from Canva, you can come in here just like we did with the previous one. And you can click and drag your audio. Boom. And then when you play it, it's going to show you. So it's going to come up as an audiogram. That's what I call it. I don't know. And it'll have the little audio effect down there. Now, something else you can do on Canva, if you want to, is you can go and upload. You're just going to go right here, upload your own audio file. So let's say you have a podcast recording that you did. You recorded your podcast. You have that audio file. You can upload it into Canva and do a little snippet. So you can create, you know, a video file, or you can create a graphic here like what we did, and you can add in your little snippet of your audio from your podcast to kind of direct people over and listen to your podcast. So it's super cool. Again, there's so many things that you can do with Canva. I hope this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.